Hello, this is Nikola Tesla, and I am speaking from the dimensions. Well, basically saying to you that I, as Nikola Tesla, did not really die, and that I do indeed still exist. And I'm here to just share with you my experience, basically, who I am now, and how I'm experiencing myself in the dimensional existence. So, my life here on Earth, as many still follow and still relate to, was quite a fascinating one, and I would like to share with you mostly just a little snippet of what it is that I experienced while I was here. But what I realized since I was a child, I could see and dream mostly. I dreamt, and while I was walking, I saw many, many inventions in my mind's eye, if you want to call it that. And I could see many manifestations of inventions, if you want to call it that, because it's not really that it was inventions. It's like that which I saw was here. It was so here that I have the ability to see how it worked, what materials I needed, you know, the intricacies and the specificity of developing such inventions that I could see in my mind, that I could see in my dreams. And it's fascinating because even in my dreams, while I was asleep, but it's not really that I was asleep, it was like just while I was in bed, and since I was a child, so it was about 4, 5, maybe 7 years old, during that time I started seeing these inventions. And I could actually see how exactly to make them. I could see how exactly, as I've said, the materials I needed, what they're used for. And I realized that as a child, I'm certain not many people would believe what it is that I was seeing, and that I actually knew how to make these things. And so as a child, I started writing what I've seen before I go to sleep, and it was usually an hour or two before I'd actually go into deep sleep. It was a kind of the alpha stage experience I had. And in that time, I actually saw myself from the start to the finish, with all the materials laid out before me, make what is necessary to be made as the inventions that I'd seen in my mind. And I had many books I had that I'd made my notes like a diary, that I'd write down what it is exactly that I was seeing, what it is that it's used for. And I realized that what I was seeing was actually maybe 10 years, maybe even 100 years before my time, in terms of the possibility of such inventions to be conceived by the human mind. It's like in that moment that I was seeing these inventions while I was lying in my bed, that our alpha stage access point that I was able to experience, was that it was like a futuristic experience, that my mind was not limited to a space-time continuum in terms of first going through a process of having the ability to conceive what I had seen as inventions and manifestations of inventions. And my mind was very expansive. It's like I had no space-time linear constriction in my mind, but rather a vast expansive nature, that anything that is possible and able to be conceived is right here. You know, we don't have to go through a process of first difficulty of having to gather ideas or possibilities or abilities to invent certain structures and manifestations and designs to make life more simpler and more profound. And so at the age of 7, around about 7, 13, I started playing around with these inventions that I'd seen in my mind, and I had my secret place at my house where I used to stay, where I gathered as much materials as I had been able to. And it was difficult during that time because I didn't have the materials I required to build these inventions and these designs and these manifestations that I had seen. And I'd seen many, hundreds. By the time I actually started, I had about maybe 728 designs all in all. You know, that had much to do with electrical movement, just basic manifestations and designs that would make life much more simpler, much more easier for humanity. And I knew that what I'm able to do here, what I'm able to see while, and it was mostly when I went to bed, it was mostly when I was just about to go to sleep that I'd have the ability to access that alpha stage expansive mind experience with no space and time, like a quantum time, where I'd see whatever is necessary to be done. And I mean, it would come randomly. I just lie down on my bed and I breathe and I remain silent. I was always silent. My mind was always silent. It's interesting. I never really thought of anything. I was quite present in my experience. And that's where these things just started coming. At first I ignored them, you know, because I thought I was kind of going crazy. But then I realized, you know what, whatever I'm seeing is actually quite possible to design. Although the materials might not exist yet, but I'm certain I'm even able to manifest those materials. And that's what I did. And that's what my life had become. And, you know, it was quite difficult during that time because many people would find me difficult to relate to and think I'm crazy and think I'm mad. And, you know, these things that you're seeing is impossible to design. And I mean, our doors closed on me fucking multiple times, always, because people said, that is impossible, and you don't have the materials to make it, and that doesn't exist yet, and why do you want that, and why do, you know, fucking all these questions came, but I kept wanting to press out to the people that this that I was seeing in the silence of my mind, in the silence of myself, I know how to do it. I know what I need to make it. I know exactly how it works. I know exactly what it's required for. And if you just give me what I need, I can show you. And no one wanted to support me in that. You know, when I was a child, I made the simplest ones that I saw in the beginning. But these images became more pertinent and more specific. And I mean, it's amazing stuff. And like I had this one invention that I'd seen that I hadn't made, but at the moment that many governments are using, is it's like a little box, right? And it focuses on a frequency wave, electromagnetic frequency wave that moves. Now, what I've designed within it is like it represents the human mind, the center point of the human mind. And what I've done is I've related that frequency to the center point frequency of the human mind. Now, this is what I've seen while I was just lying in my bed, as always, breathing, and I just accessed that point of quantum time, that point of expansion, the point of infinity, where I see what is necessary to be made. Well, it just kind of comes naturally. And what I saw was that machine, and in the center point you have that magnetic frequency. But you have to, now I was shown in that moment also the human being, right? And what I was shown, and the human mind was like opened, and this little box design was shown how it must be set to the frequency of the frequency in which the human mind in the center point is currently resonating. So what you're able to do actually with that machine, and I didn't build it, understand, I had many works that many people had taken, mostly in America, that are using most of these techniques to kind of program human beings and influence them in such a way. So I designed this box. This is now what I've written down in my diaries. And I drew the human that I'd seen, and I drew this little box that I'd seen. I drew the center point of the human mind, and I drew this box and this electromagnetic frequency pulse. But it's just a simple metallic, I wouldn't say it's a simple metallic, but it's like it comes up. Now, in this box is like a platform, and it has these four points that comes out like this. And the center point, you have like a pillar, a small little pillar that comes up.